For all the stat folks out there, as y'all may know, the Redskins unfortunately finished the season 7-9 after losing the season finale to the Giants again. I have a few stats y'all may not know that may be a little encouraging for y'all heading into the offseason, but there's also some alarming stats that I feel y'all need to know and be aware of. So let's start with some team offensive stats. Let's get it. Our offense finished 17th in the league in yards per game with 324.9 and finished 16th in points per game with 21.4. Even though our offensive line basically had ads on Craigslist, our best playmakers Jordan Reed and Chris Thompson missed a total of 16 games combined, and we lost two 1,000-yard receivers in summer 2017. So that's a little room for optimism. I want to hear the 16 teams below us excuses. To dig deeper, we were 15th in points scored per play with 0.348. We were also 16th in red zone scoring at 54.35%. This is a big step in the right direction after we finished 30th in the previous season. We were 14th in yards per play with 5.3, and happily, we were 6th in the league in 4th down conversion percentage at 56.25%, which is an improvement from our flat 50% from the previous season. But sadly, we were 20th in time of possession percentage per game with 49.47%, which is not much of an improvement from the previous season's 49.23%, losing the time of possession battle 2 years in a row. Not good. We were also 31st in third down conversion percentage at 32.35%, which is a huge decline from our 45.23 third down conversion rate in 2016, which had us ranked 5th in the league. That has to be a big focus for us in the offseason. Now let's talk about our team rushing stat. We were only 23rd in rushing attempts per game at 25.1. We need to be more balanced than that, but at least this is a slight improvement from our previous season 23.7 rushing attempts per game, which had us ranked 4 spots lower at 27th in 2016. But this slight increase didn't mean an increase in rushing yards per game. We finished 28th in the league this past season in rushing yards per game with 90.5. Not good at all. Definitely another point of emphasis over the offseason. Now to the team passing stats. We were 20th in the league in passing attempts per game with 33.8. And even though we were 20th in passing attempts per game, we were 13th in passing yards per game with 234.4. Kirk also led the Redskins to being 9th in the league in passing touchdowns per game with 1.7. And even with the most injured offensive line, the Redskins were only 21st in sacks allowed per game at 2.6. Now on to the team defensive stats. Injuries are not an excuse, and the Redskins defense was 27th in allowed points per game at 24.2. But at least the defense ranked 12th in red zone defense with only allowing 50.88% of opponent red zone trips to result in touchdowns. This still needs to be emphasized these next few months, because that still means that we allow the team to score a touchdown basically half of the time they reach within our 20-yard line. But at least we weren't terrible at it. We were also 22nd in yards allowed per game at 347.9. That is very unhealthy. We were 14th in first downs allowed per game at 19.2. Have to cut that down too. But we were 7th in third down conversion percentage allowed at 36.73%, which is a huge improvement from the 2016's ranking of dead last 32nd in the league, allowing 46.63% in the 2016 season. Shouts out to the Redskins for improving on that. Keep it up. But we were in the bottom of the barrel in fourth down conversion percentage allowed, ranked at 26th in the league, allowing 60% of fourth down conversions to be converted. Ugly. Now where we were worst at was rushing defense. We were dead last in the league, allowing 134.1 rushing yards per game. Terrible. Absolutely unacceptable no matter how many injuries we had. But our pass defense was nowhere near as bad. We finished 9th in the league in passing yards allowed per game at 213.8. This is a nice improvement from our 25th ranked 258.1 passing yards allowed per game in the 2016 season. But sadly, the Redskins were 30th in the league in fumbles lost per game at 0.9, which led to us being ranked 25th in turnover margin per game at negative 0.2, which is terrible. You should never be negative or neutral. We have to emphasize turnovers in the offseason. But on a good note, we were 6th in the league with only 5.8 penalties per game, and we were ranked 2nd in 45.8 penalty yards per game. This is a good sign from Gruden's discipline amongst his players. In some last random stats, we gained 21 first downs from penalties while our opponents gained 31 first downs from penalties. So even though we were a great team, penalty and discipline wise overall, We allowed some ugly first downs from penalties this past season, 31 of them to be exact. And also, shouts out to Dustin Hopkins and Nick Rose for making a combined 24 out of 28 field goal attempts this season. Nick Rose was a good replacement for Dustin Hopkins while he was hurt. Now let's move on to some player-specific stats that were noteworthy to me. Kirk finished the season with 540 passing attempts, which is the fourth most in Redskins history. Kirk also finished the season with 4 rushing touchdowns, which is 13 for his career. Kirk has now finished 4 rushing touchdowns behind Joe Theismann's franchise record of 17. I guess he won't be able to catch up now. Kirk also finished first in the NFC in passing plays of 25 plus yards with 35. Airing that thing out. Bleacher Report has him rated as the 12th best quarterback in the NFL, but he's gone now. Ryan Kerrigan has started 112 consecutive regular season games, which is the longest active streak among NFL linebackers. He has never missed a start since he was drafted. Ryan Kerrigan also finished the season with 13 sacks, which is 71.5 for his career total. Ryan Kerrigan was ranked the 4th best 3-4 outside linebacker in the NFL by Bleacher Report. His fellow position mates Preston Smith were ranked 6th and Junior Gallette was ranked 22nd. It's pretty good. Zach Brown finished with 127 tackles in the year and he missed the final 3 games. I'm sure without a doubt he would have led the league in tackles if not for those games missed. He was only behind first place by 17 tackles. Huge contribution from a new signee on a 1-year contract. I really hope we re-sign him. He was rated the 7th best inside linebacker in the NFL by Bleacher Report. Vernon Davis finished first in the NFC in average yards per reception amongst tight ends with 15. Vernon Davis was also tied for 2nd in the NFL in longest reception amongst tight ends with a 69-yard reception. Great job at replacing Jordan Reed's impact in the passing game. Just need him to block a little better. My boy, Kendall Fuller, finished tied for 2nd in the NFC in interceptions. Bleacher Report has him rated as the best slot corner in the NFL. And it's crazy because this was really his rookie season because injuries hampered any of his production and progress in the 2016 season. He is a franchise corner. I'm so sad to see him go. Miraculously, Chris Thompson, who missed the last 6 games of the season, still led all running backs in the NFL in average yards per catch with 13.1. and was also 2nd in the NFC in longest running back reception with a 74-yarder. Jamison Crowder led the team in receptions and reception yards with 789 yards and 66 receptions. Samaje Perine led the team in rushing attempts and yards with 603 yards and 175 rushes. DJ Swearinger and Kendall Fuller led the team in interceptions with 5 each. And Preston Smith is in 3rd place with 2. Proud of him. Ryan Kerrigan and Bashaud Breeland also had 1 interception return for a touchdown each. Bashaud Breeland is also more than likely out of here in the offseason. And on a final note, we had 26 players placed on injured reserve throughout the season, and 25 of them finished the season on injured reserve. One of the worst injury bugs I've ever seen. Hopefully we can not suffer the same fate in 2018. We don't deserve it. But that's it for this unique episode. Thanks for the view. What a 2017 season. Now it's time to focus on 2018 with the new players that we've traded for, the ones we'll draft in April, and some we'll re-sign, and some new signees over the offseason. I'm going to keep bringing y'all occasional updates on what the Redskins organization is doing throughout this entire offseason from December to August. This will include roster moves, draft prospects, scouting reports. I got y'all back. And make sure y'all Dolomite Fake Punch that like button, favorite, subscribe, I'll subscribe back, and most importantly, comment and share. And again, thank y'all for the support. I'll catch y'all later. I'm out.